think a classic is a great example of a book of its kind.
A classic is a book which dissolves the idea of time and distance, those things which are presented as barriers.
Previously, the classics had been rather sort of hallowed and very, very, you know, treated very gravely and were rather imposing.
There was a lot of painting, Wordsworth, Oxford.
We decided that we were not going to have any oil painting landscapes, we weren't going to have any sad eyed ladies with centre partings.
We quite like the idea of collapsing the distinction between old and new. And it's not about reading Jane Eyre because you think you should.
You know, it's a good thing to read a classic. It might make you a better person. But it wasn't ever suggested as something enjoyable, and that was our gap in the market.
Wanted to establish a look that you could take over hundreds of titles that wouldn't date rapidly. I was working on it over the weekend, I think, and I had that idea of the vintage and then the surname, and it worked.
If ever anybody asks me what I do and I'm round at somebody's house, I scan their shelves and there will always be a red spine on the shelves.
We positioned the books to the retailers essentially saying, these are brilliant books, modern readers aren't reading them. There are various reasons for that, one of which is they just haven't been told about them in the right way or haven't felt they were the right books for them.
What we wanted was books that looked like contemporary books, because all these stories are still relevant. That's why they're classics, is because they're still speaking to generations after generations.
People were really excited by what we were producing, so it just produces a great atmosphere.
The atmosphere was rather tense. You go into any bookshop then, and they had a copy of Great Expectations by Charles Dickens. You know, they had a copy of Wuthering Heights.
So I remember it as a very joyous time, and we did obviously think, oh God, is anyone going to choose our copy of Pride and Prejudice when they have many other possibilities? But we did feel like we were definitely offering something different.
Vintage classics don't come with a lot of academic paraphernalia. We really like commissioning introductions from people from within the world of books and from outside it. We publish special editions, we collaborate with interesting companies to, and artists make beautiful artwork. All the different things we do to keep classics relevant and interesting, rediscovering books which have fallen out of print or out of favour but that we think definitely still deserve to be read. It's our 10th birthday this year and we're celebrating. Hopefully we'll have another 10 years ahead of us of brilliant books.
I'm going to sum up the list as I see it in a few words.
Classy.
Life enhancing.
Approachable.
An affordable alternative to psychotherapy.
Accessible.
Irreverent.
And read.